According to the United Nations Environmental Program, up to 12.7 million metric tons of plastic has made its way to the ocean in just 1 year. The ocean has officially become the world's trash dump, and we all should be concerned. The ocean not only provides us half of our oxygen, but influences the weather, shapes the earth, and regulates our climate. We all need to want a healthy ocean, but before I fully get into that, let me tell you how my love for the ocean developed. It all started with a TV show called Dive Club. Dive Club is a Netflix series about a group of teen divers who search for their friend when she goes missing after a storm. Even though this is a teen drama, I still found myself fascinated in the underwater world. Watching the show and the teen adventure of diving just made me feel like I needed to be doing that too. For months, I could only dream about diving and exploring the depths of the sea. And then it happened. On my 10th birthday, my parents surprised me by taking me to the local dive shop. It was absolutely amazing and everything I could have imagined. After my first dive, I just knew that I wanted to do this for a living. But there is a problem. I want to dive and explore in a healthy ocean. A healthy ocean not only for me, but for you and the life beneath the surface. As a society, I believe that we should be concerned about the increase in plastic pollution in the ocean. I say this because about 2,000 trucks worth of plastic is dumped into the ocean every single day. Plus, plastic pollution is just one out of the many products of humans dumping trash into the ocean. Another big problem is that marine animals like to eat the plastic. The species most commonly killed by eating plastics are bottlenose dolphins, California sea lions, manatees, and now several species of sea turtles too. These animals like to play with the plastic, not understanding the harm that it could bring. And also due to marine animals' natural curiosity, whether items in the ocean are food or not, it leads to them eating a lot of plastic. And also, because of this, well over 500,000 marine animals die a year just from plastic pollution. Although, plastic is not just a problem for marine animals, but for humans in some ways as well. As we continue to dump plastic into the ocean, the plastics are poisoning, the chemicals are poisoning the water. These are known as endocrine disruptors. And research has suggested that human exposure could cause health impacts, including hormonal imbalances, reproductive problems like infertility, and probably even cancer. But also, what are one of the worst cases of plastic pollution, you might ask? That is the Great Pacific Garbage Patch. The garbage patch is made of over 3 trillion pieces of plastic right there in the Pacific Ocean. It's actually 3 times the size of Texas and is so large you can even see it from space. Even though this is really bad, there are still simple things that we could do to help stop the increase in plastic pollution. As an example, in my family, we switched to reusable bags, bottles, and containers. I'm still trying to help them use reusable straws too. So if you want to help save the ocean, you can make small changes to your everyday lives like this. But also, if you have 1 year, I would encourage you to volunteer for a beach, lake, or a river cleanup, because that always helps. But no matter what, always recycle if you can, please. There is a Tanzanian proverb that says, little by little, a little becomes a lot. If we all commit to do a little bit to help save the ocean, we can start to see a change for the better beneath the ocean surface.